Hi, I'm Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, here to tell you what's going on at the movies. And you know what's going on? You'll go to the multiplex this weekend and you'll close your eyes and you'll blink and you'll think that you're back in 1983. In fact, if it was 1983, these movies would probably be really good instead of just barely acceptable. Because what am I talking about? I'm talking about the A-Team. A-Team ran on TV from 1983 to 1987. Mr. T was in it. We all remember that. I pity the fool that doesn't remember it. And the other movie's The Karate Kid. The Karate Kid, remember, with Pat Morita as Mr. Miyagi and Ralph Macchio doing it. Hollywood is bereft of originality. They do not know how to think of anything new, so they go back. And this time, it's the 80s. So can I make a claim for either of these movies as being good? No, can't do it. But some of them have moments that are entertaining. Now, the A-Team, if anybody remembers or watches any kind of old TV shows on whatever network is showing them, TV Land or something like that, you can look at that and watch these guys. They were veterans of the Vietnam War, and they're basically being blackmailed because they said they robbed a bank in Saigon, so they become mercenaries, soldiers of fortune, but good guys. They used to shoot everybody, no one ever got shot. They were the worst shots in the history of the world. No one ever got shot. Mr. T would just say, fool, and that would be it. This movie is, of course, made now, and it's 2010. And in 2010, when you aim, you gotta shoot somebody. So Mr. T looked at this movie, which stars Liam Neeson as Hannibal, Bradley Cooper is Face, the Face Man, the guy with the beautiful looks like that, who just gets all the girls. And then you have one of my favorite characters, Murdoch, who is just completely nuts. He was always in an insane asylum and they would break him out to do things. And in the movie is played by Charlton Copley, who was so great last year in District 9. And then Mr. T, how can you cast anybody but Mr. T? Well, they did. They took a mixed martial arts champion fighter named Quentin Rampage Jackson, put him in the jewels, get him in the thing. He's got the dialogue down, and he's that. But they shoot to kill. And this movie is directed by Joe Carnahan, who did Narc and Smoke and Aces. And so it's edited. It's cranked up like crazy. Instead of the way the TV show works, it's just boom, boom, bong, bong, you know. You look at clips from this and you think, where am I? It's kind of incoherent action. But you know what? If you're just in that kind of mood where you just want to go to a movies and watch things blow up, and let's face it, there's millions of you who do, then it's okay, because these guys do have a nice camaraderie. Now, I'm going to bring in a quote from another critic, and that critic is Mr. T himself, who went to this movie and said, I don't like it. These people are fools, because what they're doing is they should have done a non-violent A-Team movie. I would say a non-violent A-Team movie would have made 2 cents and nobody would have been there, but far be it from me to cross Mr. T. All right, Karate Kid, Ralph Macchio was like 16 or 17 when he did this movie. Now we have Jaden Smith, the son of Will Smith, starring in this movie, who was 11 when he did this movie. He looks like he weighs about 22 pounds. So when you see him being taught to be the karate expert, actually he's being taught Kung Fu, and it should have been called The Kung Fu Kid, but this is Hollywood, so who cares? I don't believe that he could have done any of this. I think the minute he did his leg extension and it went towards somebody else, he would be blown away, but that's just me. Not realistic. What's really not good about this movie, and really not good, is it's 2.5 hours long. Why, people? It's The Karate Kid. We know he'll be taught, and he gets taught by Jackie Chan. Could be better than that. I mean, I still love Pat Morita as Mr. Miyagi, but Jackie Chan's good in this movie. 2.5 hours? No. It just gets tired. And I bet you can all guess how it plays out. You know, predictable formula. I'm sorry, that's the way it is. So is there something you should see? There's something you should see, and you're going to kill me for this, is a documentary, and it's called Joan Rivers, A Piece of Work. And she is a piece of work. You think you know who this woman is? 75 years old, still on the road, still doing her comedy. She is outrageous in this movie. She's like Sacha Baron Cohen. You're going to see a side of her you never saw by watching her do red carpet interviews or something on QVC. It's actually one of the most shockingly funny movies that's out there now. There, I said it. Take it or leave it. I'm Peter Travers.